would like to introduce myself as the protagonist. I'm Rinalini Mazumdar, specializing in instrumentation and control engineering. I come from Calcutta Institute of Engineering and Management. We are working under our respected dean, our mentor, Professor Dr. Amitabh Das. The title of our project is The Development of Photoplethysmograph Systems. Now, before moving on to the further details, it is very crucial for us to know the significance of the word photoplethysmograph. Photoplethysmography is one of the simplest techniques that can be used to detect blood volume changes in the microvascular bed of tissue. The PPG signal reflects the blood movement in the vessel, which goes from the heart to the fingertips through the blood vessels in a wave-like motion, as the amount of the scattered light reflected back corresponds with the variation of the blood volume. Starting with the core details of the project, we all know the heart is the center of the cardiovascular system. When the heart pumps blood, systolic and diastolic changes take place. In the systolic phase, the heart releases the blood to different parts of the body, and the flow rate of blood is maximum in this phase. Contrary to the systolic phase, the flow rate of the blood is minimum during the diastolic phase. Due to these differences between the blood flow rates in the systolic and diastolic phases of the heartbeat, the blood flowing through different parts of the body also goes through a volumetric change. This volumetric change is detected using infrared light, and the fingertip helps us to observe the change, which is then recorded to calculate the heart rate. Coming back to the circuit details, the output of the sensor passes through three signal conditioning stages. Stage 1 of the signal conditioning concerns the output of the sensor, which passes through a passive high-pass filter having cutoff frequency as 0.7 Hz. This output then goes through the active low-pass filter having cutoff frequency as 2.34 Hz and gain as 101. Before moving on to the next stage, the output now goes through a 5K potentiometer, which is used for adjusting the gain. The flickering light reflected from the LED is an indication of the output pulse. Stage 1 is repeated once again for fine-tuning. Stage 3 of signal conditioning, which is also the final stage, concerns the output, which goes through the non-inverting offset adjustment. Here, another 5K potentiometer is used to maintain the output between 0 volt and 5 volts. This is due to the fact that Arduino Uno R3 can take the output from 0 volt to 5 volt.
In this project, we use TCRT5000, which is a reflective optical sensor with transistor output having an emitter wavelength of 950 nanometer.
We are using Arduino Uno R3, which is basically a device which helps us to display signals on the PC. It has a microcontroller named ATmega328. The analog to digital converter is a vital part of the Arduino Uno R3. It has clock speed of 16 MHz, flash memory of size 32 kilobytes. The size of static RAM is 2 kilobytes, and there are 6 analog input channels used. Friends, now we present to you a video which will show the working of the photoplethysmogram. Friends, the output signals received and displayed on the oscilloscope are further implemented in MATLAB programs to extract certain features. In our endeavor, the first feature that we extracted was heart rate calculation. In order to calculate the heart rate, we used the first derivative of PPG signal. The original PPG signal that was obtained from the Arduino Uno R3 contained high frequency noise. The single point first derivative was not able to suppress the noise given out by the original PBG signal, and hence to remove the interference, we use 3-point and 5-point derivatives which act as natural filters. Zero crossing calculation of first derivative gives the dichrotic notch or the distance between the beginning and the end of the PBG wave. Pulse interval gives the distance between the beginning and the end of the PBG waveform. Beats per minute is calculated by the formula 60 divided by pulse interval into sampling frequency.
Other features were extracted from second derivative photoplethysmogram, which is also known as APG, that is acceleration plethysmogram. The APG waveform consists of 4 systolic waves, that is A, B, C and D, and 1 diastolic wave, which is E wave. The main features of APG waveform are ratio B by A, which is Framingham risk score, ratio C by A, which shows decrease in arterial stiffness, ratio D by A, which is an index for left ventricular afterload, and ratio B minus C minus D minus E by A, which is used for evaluating vascular aging, and finally ratio B minus E by A, which is an APG aging index. We are using 5-point second derivative calculations for defining the different peaks. First, we define the window which gives a complete cycle of a PPG wave. For finding the maximum and minimum peak, we are shorting the window, after which we are arranging the peaks in descending order that gives us the consecutive first, second and third maximum and minimum peaks.
Contest because of its technological and societal significance. On the technological front, we have successfully portrayed the measurement of heart rate using innovative MATLAB programs. And on the societal front, I would like to say that why our project actually deserves to win the contest is because it is a very cost-effective process we are using, where a portable device is playing its vital role, because it actually helps us to curb all the expenses, the other extravagant expenditure. And as we all know, heart rate is a very important feature of the human body, and it helps us to monitor the human body's health. So I think these are reasons enough for us to win the contest. So finally, we come to the end of the project. I would like to conclude by saying that with further developments made in the algorithms, we can get to know how to calculate the blood pressure and detect various cardiovascular diseases. And I hope you enjoyed watching the project as much as we enjoyed making it. Okay, bye-bye. Take care.